Now, coming to the point, traffic engineering study. So basically, in the traffic engineering study, we'll learn the various type of studies or various type of traffic surveys, which will help us to improve the traffic engineering characteristics. To analyze the traffic characteristics and their movement along the identified roads, we will learn the traffic engineering study, and it also helps in design of geometric features and traffic control measures, okay, for safe and efficient traffic. Now, there are various kind of traffic engineering studies. Okay, so let us see what are those. One is traffic volume studies. There are spot speed studies, speed and delay studies, origin and destination studies, parking studies, and accident or conflict studies. Okay, so we will learn each of the studies one by one. So let's start with traffic volume studies. So the traffic volume study, one point is very important, that is, the traffic volume is also known as traffic flows. So what is the traffic volume studies? Just look at the video. What we can see, there is a blue line, right? The yellow lines are the actually guidelines, so ignore the yellow lines. Let us concentrate on the blue lines. So this is a specific part of the road, and whenever any vehicle is crossing the blue line, we'll record the vehicle. Okay, so that is how we can have some number of vehicles, and also we'll record the time duration. So to determine the traffic volume, that is the number of vehicles by the duration of counting. Okay, that is how we will determine the traffic volume. So as you can see, the unit of the traffic volume can be expressed as vehicles per hour or PCU per hour. Okay, so what is PCU? We'll come into later. So for now, just know that PCU is passenger car unit. Complete traffic volume study includes classified volume study. This is for number of different vehicles are counted. The video we have just seen that there are number of different vehicles are counted. Okay, so number of autos, number of two-wheeler, number of four-wheeler passing through. So that is classified volume study. In that study, we'll have specific numbers for each category of vehicles. Okay, there is another type of traffic volume study, that is directional study. In the directional study, actually the distribution of traffic on different lanes is calculated. Okay, suppose we need to know how many cars are coming from this to this in this time duration, and in the opposite lane how many cars are passing. Okay, so for that we will do or we will perform the directional traffic volume study. The third type of traffic volume study is turning moment study. So basically this type of study is done for intersection design. Okay, the last type of study is pedestrian volume study. Okay, so what is pedestrian volume study? This helps in planning subways, footpath, footbridge, and in pedestrian signal timing. Okay, so that is pedestrian volume study. Now, representation of traffic volume study data. So how will represent the traffic volume study data? So there is a term called average annual daily traffic, in short AADT. Okay, so AADT is the average annual daily traffic. So it is the average of 24 hour volume at a location calculated over 365 days or throughout a year. Okay. So it includes the seasonal variation of traffic. So if we calculate the average annual daily traffic data for a year, so we can have the seasonal data also. So from that, we can see the seasonal variation of the traffic flows. So this ADT, there are some formulas using which we can calculate the ADT and some expansion factors. Okay. So what are the formulas of those factors? So one is hourly expansion factor, that is 24 hour traffic volume divided by hourly volume of that particular hour. Okay. The second type of expansion factor is daily expansion factor or DEF, that is weekly traffic volume divided by average 24 hour volume that of that day. The third type of factor is average daily traffic or ADT, that is weekly volume divided by 7. Okay. And the last type of expansion factor is monthly expansion factor, that is AADT or average annual daily traffic by ADT of the month or average daily traffic of the month. Okay. So that is how to calculate the MEF. So these are the expansion factors that indicates the traffic flows. Now, the average daily traffic actually includes the weekly variation of the traffic. Okay. We need minimum 7 days count to get the ADT. Now, there is another form of representation of traffic volumes, that is trend chart. So the volume trend over a period of year is calculated in the trend chart, and it is very helpful in planning expansion design and regulation. Okay. So there are another type of thing is traffic flow map along the route. So in the traffic flow map, what we do is it gives an idea of traffic at a lane, and the thickness of the line represents the traffic volume. So there are some lines actually, and thicker the line, thicker the traffic volume. Okay. Now this thing is very important, that is 30th highest hourly volume. Okay. So based on this 30th highest hourly volume, we design the traffic. Okay. So what is this 30th highest hourly volume? It is taken as design hourly volume or design capacity. Okay. And it is exceeded 29 times in a year. Okay. Now coming to the 30th highest hourly volume, that is, see the graph. So the graph is plotted. In y-axis, it is the hourly volume as a proportion of AADT, means hourly volume by AADT. Okay. And here it is the number of hours with specified or greater volumes. Means actually what happens? Actually, suppose we have some maximum number of traffic volumes, and we choose 100 maximum hourly traffic volumes over a year. Okay, so from a yearly data, we choose 100 maximum hourly volume data, and we plot a graph taking the highest one to the lowest one. Okay, so it is not for successive days. Okay, the maximum one may be for a month of February, then for a month of April, then for a month of January. Okay. So these are the randoms, but the maximum, okay, from maximum to minimum in the water. Now, how to determine the 30th highest hourly volume? So this one means the very first one is highest, then second highest traffic volume, then third highest, then fourth highest. So in like that, we can have 30th highest volume, some between here. Okay. So let us say that the value will be something like 0.118. Okay, in this case. So this will be our design consideration, and based on it we'll design our traffic segments. Okay. So here is the end of traffic volume study. Thank you.